Break down the Strokes, you see the legacy of an alternative rock band that really came out of their debut album. From frontman Julian Casablancas all the way down to bassist Nikolai, then the Strokes have shared a lot of success. And not only that, but each member has really done a great job at pursuing their own solo projects as well. But I've been wanting to make a video on Julian Casablancas for quite some time now, not only for who he is, but also for just the role that he has played in the music industry today. He has shared a lot of success with the Strokes, has pursued his own solo career, has made music with The Lonely Island and so many other projects that you would have never expected him to be on. I think it's time to like pay some respect to Julian and just dive straight into this video all about the Strokes' Julian Casablancas. Julian Casablancas, if you don't know already, was born on August 23rd, 1978, and he was born in New York City, New York. He can be seen as an American musician, singer, songwriter, and record producer. He is best known as the lead singer of American rock band The Strokes, which were founded in 1998. He has also shared a lot of pride in founding The Voids, which was founded in 2013. Casablancas has also led a solo career, which The Strokes held back a couple years ago, and he released one album, Phrases of the Young, which was released on November 3rd, 2009. Over the years, Casablancas has also collaborated with several other artists on their work, examples being The Lonely Island's 2009 album Incredibad and Daft Punk's 2013 album Random Access Memories. Julian founded the independent record label Cult Records in 2009 and initially used it as sort of an outlet to produce his own solo releases. Cult Records, though, later became a standalone label, and in June 2014, they ended up merging and just working with another company named Cobalt in order to just become more of like a label services and a legitimate label as a whole. But that can just be seen as a brief overview of his music career as of now. Let's talk about his early life a little bit and see just what kind of background he had and what he came from. So Julian's father, John Casablancas, who actually passed away a couple years ago, was the founder and just the CEO of a modeling talent agency. And Julian's mother, which was actually former Miss Denmark back in 1965, her name was Jeanette Christensen. When Julian was 8 years old though, his parents actually divorced, but this is where a very significant figure came into Julian's life, his stepfather. His stepfather, who was a painter, actually shaped Casablancas' early musical career taste by exposing him to music such as The Doors, which was marked differently from mostly Phil Collins influenced music that he listened to as a child. When it came time to start networking and just like the early development of The Strokes, Casablancas knew the bassist of The Strokes, Nikolai Fritur, since they were six, while both attending the Lycée Français de New York. And when he was 14, Casablancas' father sent him to the Institut Le Rosy, a boarding school in Switzerland, where he met future Strokes member Albert Hammond Jr. Casablancas later returned to New York and attended the Dwight School with two other future Strokes, Nick Valenzi and Fabrizio Moretti. And though Julian never finished high school, he did end up taking a GED class and got his GED and eventually attended the Five Towns College, where he enjoyed himself in a lot of music enveloped courses. But as far as just a sneak peek to the origins of the Strokes and Julian's role in that development, Casablancas met the guitarist Nick Valenzi and drummer Fab Moretti back in school in Manhattan. He reconnected with guitarist Albert Hammond Jr. when the latter moved to New York. The band was formed in 1998 when Hammond was accepted into the band, with Casablancas as the lead vocalist and the main songwriter. The band began rehearsing a 14-song set, which included Alone Together, Barely Legal, Last Night, The Modern Age, New York City Cops, Soma, Someday, Take It or Leave It, and This Life, which was an early version of Trying Your Luck. Most of the songs now feature different lyrics, and at the time a demo was actually sent to Rough Trade Records in the UK, and it sparked a lot of interest there, leading to the first release via website of the UK magazine NME, who gave away a free MP3 download of Last Night. And this was a week prior to the physical release of the Modern Age EP in 2001. As soon as the EP came out, it immediately sparked a bidding war among record labels, the largest for a rock and roll band in years. Shortly after, The Strokes' critically acclaimed debut album, Is This It, was released. After the release of two other albums, Room on Fire and First Impressions of Earth, and several major tours, the band took a 5-year break before returning with their fourth album, Angles, in 2011. And though the title is very deceiving, a lot of people have actually noticed this. It is Angles and not Angels. I made that mistake a long time ago, and I really did see it as Angels for the longest time. Moreover, this was followed by several headlining appearances at music festivals, including Reading, Coachella, Lollapalooza, and Austin City Limits. The band went on to release Come Down Machine in 2013 as their last album under the contract with longtime label RCA, for which they did no promotion. The band released an EP, Future, Past, and Present, on Casablanca's own label, Cult Records, in 2013. So taking everything into account as to where the Strokes are right now, then we can see that they've really progressed since the Modern Age EP all the way down to Future, Past, and Present. The foundation of all their music has really remained the same. Like, when you hear their songs, you can tell, like, yes, this is definitely a Strokes song. This is Nick and Albert on the guitars doing the crazy, just harmonious and just like very synchronized sounds that they have been doing so well for so long now. Hearing that signature, just like crunchy bass sound as well, just is obviously Nikolai behind the bass itself. And then when you finally just hear Julian's vocals, they are just so distinct that you can just recognize him from not only his features, but more importantly, the projects and the success that he has shared with the Strokes. And to briefly just dive into my personal testimony as to how I came across the Strokes, I remember back in middle school, I had a friend who mentioned that his brother was a huge Strokes fan. And at the time, he was trying to convince me that I knew who they were, and at this point, I just played along. I was like, yeah, I love the Strokes. And then finally, I just remember going home that night and looking up who the Strokes were, and instead of actually starting off with a Strokes song, I was actually already a fan of The Lonely Island at the time. And at this time, Boombox had actually just dropped, so I watched the Boombox music video and I noticed that someone named Julian Casablancas was featured, and the dude went hard. So then finally I just looked up Julian as just who he was as a person, just wanting to know who he was, and I realized and I made the connection that he was actually the lead singer of the Strokes. I just kind of sat there and I was like, well, okay, if I can enjoy him as a feature, then let's see what he's up to with this band. I immediately fell in love with the band and all their work, and at this point I believe The Modern Age, Room on Fire, and First Impressions of Earth had just come out. The first Strokes album that actually clicked with me though was definitely Room on Fire. I just loved every single track, and I mean, a big part of it was because of the fact that Reptilia was just such a great song at the time, and now it's probably one of like the hardest songs for me to listen to by them because it has been so overplayed. But Room on Fire as a whole just has so many other hidden gems in there that I definitely recommend to anybody starting off. From there, I really got into First Impressions of Earth and just the sound that was created there. And then finally, when it came time to trying my hand at Is This It, I immediately fell in love with the song and just the album as a whole as well. Just that garage band kind of like sound to it that the Strokes are just really known for really captured my listening, and I immediately just wanted to explore the Strokes and just really keep up with them. I lucked out and Angles actually dropped shortly after like getting into the Strokes, like even I think just like a couple months later. And when the album came out, I know it was like very controversial because a lot of people didn't like this new sound that the Strokes were trying to project. But I personally fell in love with it, and it just really made me try to explore just the rest of the Strokes and what they're up to. Julian's solo work, album solo work. But all in all, Angles kind of played a big role in creating a concrete image of what the Strokes wanted to sound like and the direction that they were going to take from here on out. Taking a closer look at Julian and just the work that he wanted to take as well, I think it was a big part of why the Strokes took a hiatus. I think they started to have some creative differences. Ultimately, this is what the Voids were supposed to be for Julian. It was supposed to be another project where Julian could just start to explore another sound that he was really into. After Angles, I knew the Strokes were just not going to go back to their traditional sound, but instead we're going to start exploring a more like futuristic and just like cleaner guitar sampling and sounds from here on out. But when the Voids came out as their own, because they used to be called Julian Casablancas and the Voids, and then eventually just shortened it to the Voids, but when that music came out, I realized that rock from here on out was going to become a lot more experimental. Human Sadness still remains and probably is one of the best Julian Casablanca performances vocally. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, I definitely recommend you check out the song. This has just been a brief overview though on Julian Casablancas and who he is and just what he has meant to me as an artist, as an individual. I highly encourage you guys to check out both The Voids and The Strokes if you haven't already. And let me know down in the comments, do you have a favorite Strokes album or just favorite Julian Casablancas like moment? If I had to include a feature, I would definitely say his Daft Punk feature just ranks really highly. I'm excited to finish the rest of the series and cover the rest of the members of the Strokes. Stay tuned, make sure to like and subscribe if you are new to the channel, and I will catch you guys in the next video.